Welcome to Analytics with Max. In this video, I'm going to talk about what is the salary of Power BI developer. This is the most often asked question to us. You can be a fresher and you want to get into Power BI, or you are an experienced professional in another technology, you want to switch your career in Power BI, or a non-IT professional who want to switch to Power BI. Or you are already working in Power BI and you want to know what is the salary range currently in the industry. And this is the video for you. Let us jump into today's topic. What is the salary of Power BI developer? If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin with industry standard. Try to understand what you mean by industry standard, how it can be defined. And before jumping into this topic, like I said about you, if you are a fresher, what will be the salary? For freshers, my advice is, you do not need to think about anything about a salary, right? For a fresher, getting a job itself is a nightmare nowadays. So once you learn Power BI, you get a salary, you forget about the salary, just join the company. You gain the knowledge because you will understand how the industry is working, the organization, software industry will work, how the requirement comes, how you need to develop the reports, how you need to face the client. That is very important. So for freshers, this video is not applicable. This video is meant only for the experience. With this note, what I mean by industry standard, right? Let's talk about in India. So typically 5 to 6 years back, I'm recording this on 2021 December, the industry standard is like, if you have experience of 10 years, say for example, 1.5, 10 into 1.5, that is 10 years into 1.5 is 15 lakhs. When you have 10 years experience, if you are getting 15 lakhs, that will be average salary. Maybe some companies may giving 20 or 25. That is second part of the story. But if someone is having 10 years, if you take an average, the 15 lakhs will be the average salary. So now, due to pandemic, people having attrition rates, the industry standard becomes 2 to 2.5 range. So I'm taking the minimum count. If you have 5 years, let's say 5 years, into two, if you are getting 10 lakhs, 1 million INR in any software jobs, right, then it is very decent. It is good. I'm saying even in Power BI, you will get average salary around this package. Okay. So because Power BI is not very new, it exists from 2011 with some small tools and add-ons as a Excel. People started using it from 2015 as it becomes a unique product that combined all the individual packages like Power Query, Power BI, all those stuffs. Forget about it. Today's topic we'll focus on. We are debating. So basically, if you are getting around the years of experience into two, that is pretty decent. That might be, you may be hearing like some people are getting more than what you are getting, right? Maybe if he is getting 5 years experience, he may be getting 15 lakhs, 20 lakhs, 25 lakhs. Forget about these people. They are very less number of people who get such a salary, right? So basically, like some startup companies or some companies who need some huge demand, right? They will get it. And also you should understand what are other skills this person, whoever getting highest package, having apart from Power BI. He might be knowing Power BI, SSIS, data warehousing, all other stuffs. It's not only Power BI. Okay, that is the point I want to make. So if you're getting average salary, that is experience into two, then it is well and good in India. In USA, I am not saying about this years of experience, because in USA it will be average of $80,000 to $90,000. So where I have taken these stuffs, I'm not telling just like with my experience. Like this is from these websites, Glassdoor, Payscale and Radacard. So What are these websites? So these websites collect information from the employees who worked previously in those companies in particular technologies. So these websites provide reports to us. In that way, we can able to analyze or understand what is the salary trend for this particular technology. So you can see here in Glassdoor, in United States, the average is based on 114 salaries. Power BI developer makes this salary. Okay. When it comes to India, let's try to change India here. You can click on India here. Then you can see the result. It is 5,50,000 INR is the your average salary. That is based on 251 salaries only. Okay, you can see from here, you need to understand this. So it's only based on 251 salaries. There will be huge opportunities in Power BI. Maybe in India itself, there will be 1 million people working in Power BI. But there are only based on 251, we cannot come to a conclusion. Okay, so Power BI is similar to another software only. I mean, it's similar to another software tool. So that is what I mentioned in a general industry standard. So in case of Power BI, you will get 5,50,000 as the average salary, and based on experience it will vary. And interesting thing, pay scale is similar to Glassdoor. You can go and check it out. The interesting thing I want to highlight here is, like, Radacard is you might aware of, right? They have he will train people, and this Radacard has published every year one report. They will collect from people, the real people who is working in Power BI. The interesting results over here, even here you can see United States, there out of 194 participants, it is around same, that is 104k, it is same like 100k US dollars. When I switch to India, so what will be the average salary? Let us see. It is based on 23 participants, it is very less. You can again see it is 1 million. And based on this, you can see how many people has entered their salary. BI analyst itself, like 8 lakhs. And you can see from the experience, 2 to 3 years experience. So 2 to 3 years experience, 825 is the average. As I said, it is more than two or three years experience. I mean, years of experience into or three they are getting. Okay, so whoever entered here, they are having more salary, I can say, right? I mean, this is the standard now. So 2 to 2.5 is the standard. If they are getting it, it is well and good. So again, I am repeating, like, based on these 23 participants, we cannot come to a conclusion. We are saying the this is the average in the industry. So don't believe, like, what I'm trying to say is, like, out of this 23, when you take average 1 million, that is 10 lakhs is the average salary. So don't believe, like, someone who is getting 20 lakhs per annum. So if you study Power BI, you will get 20 lakhs, 30 lakhs, like that. It is not like that. That is what I want to conclude. So what is the key takeaway for this video is, like, Power BI is similar to any other software. It is not no wonder, like, it will not do wonders. There is only one tool in the market that will do anything in BI, right? There are a lot of competitors. Power BI is very niche because of its cost is very cheap, and there are a lot of support and easy to collaborate. Everyone can easily learn. That is why it is so famous. So it is niche skill now. Definitely niche means it is up in the market, very hot in the market. For next 3 to 5 years, it will be very niche. After that, it becomes very normal technology. So don't get into the mindset like, if you learn Power BI, your life will be settled. You have to learn Power BI along with other technologies in order to have a safer life, or say for job security? Like, what are the technologies you need to learn? SQL along with Data Warehouse, SSIS, SSAS. In case of Azure, you go for Azure Data Factory and Azure Data Lakes, Azure Synapse. Those things you should keep learning it. Then only your life will be secure. I hope you got the point what I'm trying to convey here. Power BI alone is not enough. Power BI is similar to any other technology. You will get average salary based on the other software's tools, whatever they are providing. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.